Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and in today's video, we'll learn how to do the floating head dance effect inspired by some recent TikTok videos. Let's jump right into Final Cut Pro and get started. Skim your clip and place your playhead on the frame you want to use for a floating head. Press M on your keyboard to add a marker here. Without moving your playhead, add a freeze frame here by using the keyboard shortcut Option F. Select your freeze frame clip and drag it up one layer in your timeline. When you do this, you actually remove the frame from your bottom layer, so we need to add it back. Select the start point of your second clip and ripple trim it out one frame by using the comma key on your keyboard. What we need to do next is isolate just the head on our subject. Select the freeze frame clip, open the effects browser, and from the masks category, add a draw mask to this clip. In this example, my subject has dark hair against a white background, so I'll use a combination of the draw mask and a luma keyer to better isolate the hair. But you might be able to get away with just using a mask. I'll zoom in on my viewer window. Change the shape type to B-spline for nice rounded corners. And add control points to outline my subject's head. When I get to my subject's hair, I'll just add control points around the outside and make sure all the hair is inside the mask. Click the first control point to close the mask. Hold down the Option key and drag up on your freeze frame clip to make a copy of it. Make sure it lines up directly above the original clip. Select the stop clip and press V to disable it for now. Select the bottom clip again, go back to the effects browser, and from the keying category, add the luma keyer. Switch to map view and adjust the luma sliders until the subject's hair is mostly white and the rest of the frame is completely black. Switch back to composite view, re-enable your top clip, and to make things a bit easier to see, disable the bottom video layer. Adjust the control points on your top layer and move them into your subject's hair to remove the light background. You may have to adjust the luma sliders of your middle layer to better isolate it. Once you're done, re-enable your video layer and combine the top two freeze frame layers into a compound clip with a keyboard shortcut Option G. Move and ripple trim your compound clip until the end of it lines up with the marker you made at the start. Make sure the compound clip layer is selected, and with your playhead on the marker in the video inspector, add keyframes to all your transform parameters. Move the playhead back about 1 or 2 seconds. Click the transform button and use either the on-screen controls or the transform controls in the video inspector to move the freeze frame clip off-screen. Let this clip render out, and here's what we have so far. Move your playhead to the next frame you want to use and repeat the previous steps. So add a marker, make a freeze frame clip, and layer it above your video clip. Replace the frame you just took out. Add a draw mask and outline the subject's head. Make a copy of your freeze frame clip, disable it, and add a luma keyer to the bottom freeze frame. Re-enable your top clip and adjust the mask. Make a compound clip and animate it with keyframes. Do this as many times as you need for a cool floating head effect like this. I do realize this takes quite a bit of time, but as you just seen, the finished product is well worth it. If you enjoyed this video or would like to learn other cool effects seen on TikTok or anywhere else, let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.